Good morning, children. So in your previous class, we have discussed that there are three types of means of transport, and they are land transport, air transport, and water transport. And in a land transport, so the land transport are divided into two types. One is a roadways and another one is a railways. So in your previous class already we have discussed about the roadways, and now come to the railways. Railways. Railways are introduced by the British. Trains are used for carrying bulky goods over long distances. So, trains or rails. Trains or rails are used for carrying bulky goods for long distances. So, the trains are used for carrying bulky goods. Bulky good means heavy. Bulky goods. Bulky goods means heavy goods. So rails are used for carrying bulky goods. So rails are used for carrying bulky goods or heavy goods for to travel long distances. They are also convenient for traveling short and long distances. So trains are also convenient for the short and also for the long distances. Goods trains carry raw material to factories and industries. So there are two types of trains. So some trains are carry goods. Those trains we call goods trains. And some trains are there which we use to travel from one place to another place. So there are two types of trains. Some trains are carrying only the goods, and some trains are used by the people travel one place for the out to the one place to the other place. So goods trains carry raw materials to factories and industries. So goods trains carry only the goods. And goods trains carry raw material to the industries or to the factories. They also carry finished products to different parts of the country and to the ports for export. So trains carry the raw materials to the industries. So goods trains also carry the finished materials, that means products which are finished from the industries. They are also carrying finished products to different parts of the country and to the ports for export. Railways play an important role in the growth and development of industries in every part of the world. So railways are very important means of transport in all over the world. The USA has the largest network of railways in the world. So USA has the largest network of railways in all over the world. continents, not countries. In some continents, railways connect cities on the eastern coast to the western coast. So, railways connect the cities which are in the eastern coast and in the western coast. Such long distance railway lines are called transcontinental railways. Long distance railway lines are called transcontinental railways. Transcontinental railways. Long distance railway lines. Long distance railway lines. Long distance railway lines. So long transcontinental railway means these are the railways which connect the cities which have the long distance. So that railway lines we call transcontinental railways. These are transcontinental railways connect the cities which have the long distance. Those railways we call transcontinental railways. Countries like the USA, Canada and Australia have such large railway networks. So the countries like USA, Canada and Australia. So USA, Canada and Australia. These countries have this type of railways. USA, Canada and Australia. This type of big countries have transcontinental railways. Japan, China and France have some of the fastest trains in the world. So Japan, China and France have the fastest train in the world. Fastest train means a train which runs very fastly. So these type of trains we can found in Japan, China and France. They run at a speed of over 430 km per hour. So the fastest trains runs over 430 km per hour. Fastest trains. Fastest trains. These trains runs very fastly and they run 430 km per hour. An underwater railway tunnel links France with the United Kingdom. So underwater railway is connect with the France and France. So underwater railway connect the tunnel links an underwater railway tunnel links France with the United Kingdom. So an underwater railway connect with the France and the United Kingdom. An urban railway system is called metro rail. Metro rail. Urban रेलवे सिस्टम है ना, अर्बन रेलवे सिस्टम। सो अर्बन रेलवे सिस्टम गोज बी कॉल्ड अ मेट्रो रेल और अ मेट्रो ट्रेन। दिस मेट्रो ट्रेन्स रन्स इन द अंडरग्राउंड लंडन न्यूयॉर्क टोक्यो दिल्ली कोलकाता एक्सेट्रा आर ऑल सर्व बाय द मेट्रो सिस्टम। सो इन टोक्यो टोक्यो दिल्ली एंड कोलकाता कोलकाता लंडन न्यूयॉर्क। सो इन लंडन न्यूयॉर्क कोलकाता दिल्ली टोक्यो इन ऑल दी सिटीज वी कैन सी दी मेट्रो ट्रेन्स। दीज मेट्रो ट्रेन्स रन वेरी फास्टली। दीज मेट्रो ट्रेन्स रन ऑन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। टुडे इंडिया हैज द लार्जेस्ट रेलवे नेटवर्क इन एशिया एंड द फोर्थ लार्जेस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड। सो इन ऑल ओवर द एशिया सो इंडिया हैज द लार्जेस्ट रेलवे नेटवर्क। शताब्दी एंड राजधानी आर सम ऑफ द सुपर फास्ट ट्रेन्स इन द इंडिया। शताब्दी एंड राजधानी रिमेंबर दिस वन शताब्दी एंड राजधानी दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द ट्रेन्स। शताब्दी एंड राजधानी दीज आर द फास्टेस्ट ट्रेन्स इन इंडिया। फास्टेस्ट ट्रेन्स इन इंडिया। सो इन इंडिया शताब्दी एंड राजस्थानी सॉरी राजधानी ओके शताब्दी एंड राजधानी दीज टू आर द नेम्स ऑफ द ट्रेन्स। सो दीज ट्रेन्स आर द फास्टेस्ट ट्रेन्स ऑफ द इंडिया। शताब्दी एंड राजधानी आर सम ऑफ द सुपर फास्ट ट्रेन इन इंडिया। द नेटवर्क ऑफ मेट्रो ट्रेन मेट्रो रेल सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो डेवलपिंग एट ए फास्ट पेस। सो द नेटवर्क ऑफ मेट्रो ट्रेन मेट्रो रेल और मेट्रो ट्रेन सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो डेवलपिंग एट ए फास्ट पेस। सो द नेटवर्क ऑफ मेट्रो ट्रेन इज ऑल्सो डेवलपिंग वेरी फास्टली। एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट। वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट। नेक्स्ट वन ट्रांसपोर्ट इज सेकेंड वन मीन्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट इज वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट। द अर्लिएस्ट मीन्स ऑफ वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट वेर राफ्ट एंड बोट्स। राफ्ट एंड बोट्स इन अर्लियर डेज पीपल यूज द राफ्ट एंड बोट्स एज अ ट्रांसपोर्ट। राफ्ट मीन्स दीज आर ऑल्सो द टाइप ऑफ बोट्स। राफ्ट दीज आर ऑल्सो द टाइप ऑफ बोट्स। सो इन अर्लियर डेज पीपल यूज टू ट्रैवल दीज राफ्ट एंड बोट्स बाय द वॉटर। द इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड एंड पॉपुलेशन डिमांडेड इंप्रूवमेंट इन मीन्स ऑफ वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट। So the increase in the population demanded the improvement in the means of water transport. So new boats filled with the steam engines were built. So in earlier days of people used to travel the raft and the boats. because of that they can, the ships can run the very fastly. They could carry more goods and people and even more go faster than raft and boats. The ships can carry goods and also the people, and the ships can move or run faster than the boats and raft and boats. Today big ships run on diesel and steam engines. So in nowadays big ships can run on a diesel also on the steam engine. They carry raw materials and finished goods from one place to the other place. So the big ships or ships can carry the raw materials and also the prepared materials from the industries. So heavy cargo such as goods, grains, raw material and mineral ores are carried by ships across the oceans and seas to different parts of the world. So the ships can carry the goods, raw materials, grains and also the minerals. The ships can carry the goods, raw materials, minerals and grains from the different parts of the world. Oil is carried by special ships called tankers. So there are some special types of ships that we call tankers. So it is a special type of ship that we call the tanker. So the tankers are the special type of ship. So these tankers carry the oils. Tankers carry the oils. Water transport is cheaper than other means of transport. So compared to the other transport, water transport is very cheap. This is because unlike roads and railways, water transport requires no roads or tracks but only ports for loading and unloading the goods. So compared to the other transport, water transport is very cheap because they don't need any roads. They do not need any type of roads and tracks. Water transport plays an important role in trade and commerce between countries. So water transport plays an important role in trade and in industrial countries. Commerce means in industrial countries. So in the industrial countries, water transport plays an important role. Next, India has a long coastline. India has a long coastline. Coastline means sea areas. Remember this one, coastline. Coastline means sea areas. So India has a long coastline. Some of the important ports in India are Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai, Haldia, Paradeep, Kochi, Vishakhapatnam, Kanda, Murgaon, New Mangaluru and Nava Sheva. These all are the important ports of the India. So some of the important ports of India are Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai, Haldia. These all are the important ports of India. So Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai, these all are the important ports of India. So what is the meaning of ports? Port means these are the areas where we used to, where boats can stop. So ports are the stands of ships. Ports are the stands of ships. In India, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra and some other Indian rivers are used in as a inland water transport. So Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers are used as a inland water transport. The lagoons of Kerala logos of Kena is also used for the purpose of a water transport. So in India, Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers are used as the inland water transport. This is all about the water transport and major sea routes of the world. So in tomorrow's class, we'll discuss about the major sea routes of the world. 15th class.